Hello friends, in this video we will be discussing fixed size variable partitions or fixed unequal size partitions as a part of memory management techniques in the operating system. Look at prerequisite chart. There are two different types of memory allocation methods are available. One is a contiguous memory allocation and second one is a non-contiguous memory allocation that we'll discuss in future. Contiguous memory allocation classified into two categories. One is a single partition allocation, other one is a multiple partition allocation. Multiple partition allocation very important in a multi-programming concept. Single partition allocation in any programming. The multiple partition allocation method further divided into two categories. One is a fixed partitions, other one is dynamic partitions. Dynamic partition method I will discuss in a future video. The fixed partitions classified into again two categories. One is fixed equal sized partitions, other one is fixed unequal sized partitions. In this session, we will be focusing fixed unequal sized partitions. In the fixed unequal sized partitions, we will be discussing what are the strengths and weaknesses of single queue and multiple queue. Why do we want to move from the single queue to multiple queue? Fixed size variable partitions as a part of multiple partition allocation as shown in the prerequisite chart. Fixed partitions are categorized into two categories such as a fixed equal size partitions and fixed size variable partitions. Fixed equal size partitions I explained with example in previous videos. Now we are focusing fixed size variable partitions. Before going to fixed size variable partitions, we need to discuss little about fixed equal size partitions that will be help the information why we are moving from fixed equal size partition to fixed size variable partitions. Look at this picture. This is equal fixed size partitions. This is fixed size variable partitions or unequal size partitions. So, let us look into the main memory. This is main memory. Main memory is divided into two partitions. One is for operating system, other is for the user area. User area total is 40K. That 40K dividing into fixed size partitions. Fixed size partition, that means equal fixed size partitions. You see, the partition size is fixed and also every partition size is same. So this is called equal fixed size partitions. Look at this picture. Fixed size variable partitions. The main memory is divided into two partitions, one for operating system. The user area 40K divided into fixed partitions. The partition sizes are variable. It is called fixed sized variable partitions or unequal sized partition. Let us take a sample input incoming processes P1, P2, P3. Let us look into this requirement of P1 9K, requirement of P2 19K, requirement of P3 12K. Now I want to load these processes into the main memory. Suppose if I select the equal fixed size partitions, if I want to load, what are the possible consequences? Let us see. P1, you see, P1 size requirement is, P1 requirement is 9K. So 9K is less than or equal to 10K. So sufficient memory is available. Then I can load the P1 into this partition. Let us go for the P2. P2 requirement is 19K, but here is each partition size is 10K. So I should not able to load into this user area. And P3 requirement is 12K. Even P3 also, I should not able to load into this user area. Even sufficient memory is available, but memory is not available in a contiguous manner. Why means this is a fixed size partitions. So I am able to load only one process with the help of equal fixed size partitions. So let us look into the unequal fudged partition. You see the requirement is P1 9K, P2 19K, P3 12K. You see P1 I can load into the third partition, and next P2 I can load into the last partition. After some time P3 also I can load once the P2 swap out. So I should able to load all the processes with the help of unequal fixed sized partitions. In the equal fixed sized partitions, I am able to load only one process. Remaining, I should not able to load. Like this, there are certain drawbacks are there in the equal fixed sized partitions, and even in the unequal sized partition also certain drawbacks are there. But unequal sized partition may be better than equal fixed sized partitions in certain cases. In what cases means? You see, let us look this example for this kind of examples. So generally the program size may be varied, may not be same. Program 1 size 2, program 2 size may be varied in general. So there are two possible ways to assign a processes to partitions. When I want to select a process, I want to assign to the a respective partition. For this assignment process, there are two methods are available. One is a single queue and other one is a multiple queues. Look into this. This is single queue method and this is multiple queue method. You see that. You see, if I maintain the single queue, suppose if we are waiting at a ticket counter, then if they are maintaining a single queue, then how do we feel? You see, then we feel like, oh, if there are two or more, three queues are there, then I should get the ticket in a shortest amount of time. Okay, like there are certain weaknesses are there with a single input queue. So then we want to move to the multiple input queue. The same size of the data that is divided into multiple queues. When we divide it into multiple queues, then the processing time will be reduced. So that is what the advantage with the multiple queue. Then what are the weaknesses and strengths that we'll be discussing in the next slide. Fixed size variable partitions, the single queue. Single queue, only one ready queue for scheduling the processes. If any pre-block size greater than or equal to process size, it will simply join instead of waiting for the suitable block size. As for the single queue, simply join instead of waiting for the other block, exact suitable block. Let us take an example. The main memory is divided into two partitions. This user area divided into variable partitions. You see, partition 1, partition 2, partition 3, partition 4. Like the sizes are available. Let us take my input processes. I want to load these processes into the main memory. You see P1, P2, P3, P4, P5. So P1 requirement is 4K. P2 requirement is 10K. P3 requirement is 11K. You see, if I select the first P1 and I'll be going to check with the suitable partition available size. P1 requirement is 4K. Available is 5K. So 4K is less than or equal to 5K. Condition is true. So immediately the P1 I can load into that respective partition. Once I load into that respective partition, actual my requirement is 4K and availability is 5K. So 1K will be wasting. So this is unused memory. This unused memory is called internal fragmentation. Let's go for the next process, P2. P2 requirement is 10K. 10K, you see that less than or equal to 6K, condition false, move to the next partition. Condition false, move to the next partition. 10K less than or equal to 20K, condition is true. So when the condition is true, then the process P2 load into this partition. Once it will be loaded into this partition, then how much unused memory, 10K unused memory. So this is what internal fragmentation. Here is internal fragmentation is more. So this is another issue with the single queue, you see that. So next process, if I select P3, P3 I should not able to load into this. Even sufficient memory is available. Where the sufficient memory is available? Internal fragmentation 1K and 10K plus external fragmentation 6K, 9K. So this is all together more than my requirement. But this memory is not available in a contiguous manner. So I should not able to load. Even P4 also, if you check it, I should not able to load. Even P5 also, I should not able to load into this. Even you see that after waiting longer amount of time, I should not get a chance to enter into this. If I swap out, I can get a chance, which is the P3 and P4 and P5. But these three must be wait a longer amount of time. These are the issues in the single queue. What are the advantages of single queue? It is a simple and minimum processing overhead. You see, it is selecting the process and trying to finding the suitable location. If it is available, loading without any further thinking. And multiple processes to execute simultaneously. Here, I should be able to execute simultaneously. Why means the user area allowing two processes. So there is a possibility of the simultaneous execution. Disadvantages: the number of partitions specified at the time of system generation or at the time of compilation. It limits the number of active processes. When the memory is divided into at the time of system generation, the number of partitions are fixed. So it is having the limitation of the degree of a multiprogramming. Suppose 4 partitions, the maximum how many processes I can load into this? Only 4 processes I can load. So it limits the number of active processes. Small job do not use partition space efficiently. Let us look into this example. P2 requirement is 10K and utilizing the 20K partition. So small jobs do not use partition space efficiently. This is one of the drawback. If the process required very small amount of memory, it is utilizing the maximum amount of partition. Small job may wait longer amount of time. Suppose P6 requires 5K and this should be wait for longer amount of time if it is follow as per the queue system, single queue system. Multiple queues. Pixel size variable partitions with multiple queues. Multiple queues. Using multiple queues, the new process loads from the secondary memory to appropriate queue without wasting the memory space irrespective of other block queues. So what we discussed in the previous method, that is single queue, there are certain disadvantages are there, and those disadvantages we are trying to overcome with the help of multiple queues. Secondary memory, suppose the processes 7 I have taken here. You see now this is what information I have. This information, first I want to do the sorting operation. Once I make into the sorting operation, with respect to the partition size, I can divide as maximum as possible number of queues. You see here is how many partitions are here, 4 partitions are there. The entire input information I am dividing into 4 partitions. Q1 is what? You see that maximum range is 16K. So you find it, what are the processes between 1 to 16K. 1 to 16K is only one available, P3. P3 I am keeping in the Q1. The next you see 17 to 24. 17 to 24 you search in this. So we need a sorting technique. Without sorting technique, I should not able to divide into as a multiple queues. The Q2 you see that P7. P7 is 22K. So range between 16 to 24. Similarly for Q3 you see that Q3 range is 25 to 68. You find in this list 25 to 68. So P1, you see, satisfying the range. P2, satisfying the range. What is 25 to 68? Next, P4 is, you see, 28. Okay, between 25 to 68. Next, P6. P6 also, you see that. 34, between 25 to 68. And P5 also, 55K. You see, And these are the processes considering as a Q3. And Q4 is see that. Q4 range is 69 to 580. But as per my input data, no processes within this range. So now Q4 is nil. So now I can process it. If I process it, then you see that Q1 processes may not be waiting much longer amount of time. And Q2 processes also may not be waiting longer amount of time. And Q3 also may be or may not be waiting longer amount of time. Q4 nil. But here certain disadvantages are there. Let us go for the advantages and disadvantages. Minimize the wastage of memory. Minimize the internal fragmentation. You see, if I follow the multiple queue, I am able to minimizing the internal fragmentation. What we observed in the previous method, for smaller job, suppose the P3 required 13K, if I allocate this partition, then how much memory will be wasting? So that is what we are trying to minimize with the help of multiple queues. You see, with respect to the partition size, we are making a queue system. So with the help of that, minimizing the wastage of memory, that is what, minimize the internal fragmentation. Minimize the waiting time also. You see, minimize the waiting time. Disadvantages, sorting incoming processes to maintain separate queues. Whatever the information I am receiving, that information I have to sort it, and again I have to divide into multiple queues. So this is extra effort is required. So for extra effort, it is consuming certain amount of time. No load balancing among the queues. Look at this, no load balancing. You see Q1, only one, Q2, only one, Q3, five processes, Q4, nil. So no load balancing. Load balancing means all the queues are not maintaining equal size of processes. This scheme is optimum from the system point of view because larger partitions remains unused. From the system point of view, this is very good because larger partitions remains unused. You see that Q4, larger partition size. So zero processes. When zero processes, this partition, I should not able to use it. In the next video, we will discuss dynamic partition method with the example. Thank you, one and all.